Hi friends, in this video, we're going to show you how you can sell Canva templates online. And if you're not familiar with Canva yet, no worries at all. We'll give you the rundown on what it is and how you can create templates that you can sell online for extra passive income. We'll also give you some tips and tricks on how you can start an online business from start to finish with as little budget as possible. And by that, we mean as close to a $0 budget as possible. And just when you thought it couldn't get any better, we'll wrap things up with a juicy Q&A session to answer all of your burning questions like how to prevent people from stealing your Canva templates and more. So buckle up and let's dive in. First, let's start with, what is Canva? Canva is a popular online graphic design tool that allows users to create professional-looking graphics, documents, presentations, posters, social media posts, and so much more. So then what is a Canva template? A Canva template is a pre-designed layout that you can use as a starting point for creating your own design on Canva. You can create your own Canva template and share or sell it to other people. The best part is that Canva makes this super easy. You can create a template link that you can share or sell to an unlimited number of people, and they can access, edit, and customize your template to their liking without affecting your original design. There are so many different Canva templates that you can create, including social media templates, presentation templates, party invitation templates, and the list goes on. As of early 2022 alone, Canva reported having over 75 million users on the platform. So it is certainly the place to be for all things graphic design. And let's face it, not everyone has the time or confidence to create stunning designs from scratch, so that's where you come in. By selling pre-made Canva templates, you can help other people to save time and create a cohesive look for their personal use or for their brand or organizations. Plus, let's not forget about the sweet passive income that you might potentially be earning. So dust off your design skills and let's get selling those templates. Step one is to go to canva.com and create your free Canva account. You have the option to go with the free version of Canva, which is pretty awesome on its own. But if you're serious about taking your design game to the next level, upgrading to Canva Pro might be the way to go because there are more advanced features at your fingertips. So you'll have the power to create better templates for your customers. Step two, it's time to create your Canva templates. First things first, you'll want to choose a design category that aligns with your expertise and your audience's needs. Are you a pro at whipping up killer social media graphics? Then focus on creating templates for Instagram posts, Facebook covers, YouTube thumbnails, or Pinterest pins. Or maybe you're great at designing more professional designs like business cards, flyers, or even resumes. Whatever your niche may be, make sure you're catering to your audience's needs. Here are several really important things that you need to know when you're creating Canva template for the purpose of selling them. Number one, you can't use Canva's pre-made templates and sell them as is. These are created by other graphic designers and these templates are their intellectual properties. You need to create your own templates from scratch to make sure that it's your original design. Number two, you can't use Canva's Pro Elements. As of today, Canva actually allows you to use Pro Elements when selling Canva templates. However, your customers wouldn't be able to use your template as intended when they themselves do not have a Canva Pro account. They'll then need to pay additional money to Canva to be able to enjoy your template, and that's just generally not a very fun experience for your customers. Now, the caveat here is that we've seen some Canva users reporting instances where sometimes a free element can become a Pro element in the future. So I recommend putting a disclaimer on your product descriptions when you're selling your Canva templates that some elements may become unavailable in the future if Canva converts some of their free elements to Pro. This is inevitable and it's not something that you can control because Canva is the one who makes these decisions. Thankfully, we haven't seen too much of these instances happening, so you don't have to worry. And you can also manage your customers with great customer support when these things happen. Finally, please read Canva's full terms of use before you start selling your Canva templates, just to make sure that you understand the guidelines that Canva has put in place for you to be able to sell Canva templates. Now that we got that out of the way, let's get those creative juices flowing and start churning out some amazing templates. Here I'm going to show you how I created this Canva template for a business card. Before we start, I'm going to quickly show you a nifty way to check how many people are searching for a business card template. You'll need a Google Ads account for this, and if you don't have one, you can sign up for free. Once I'm in my Google Ads account, I'm going to head to the Tools and Settings, and then click Keyword Planner. Now I'm going to input business card template to see how many people are searching for this keyword on Google on a monthly basis. And voila, you'll see that there is in fact a substantial number of people who are looking for these. So there's your approximate market size. You can do this for any keyword that you can possibly think of. Next, I'm going to Google common business card size to make sure that my business cards can be used by most people. Afterward, I'm going to find some inspiration on Pinterest. Once you start selling a lot more Canva templates, it's better to focus on a specific niche or art style. This way, your online store or brand will be memorable to your target audience. I like this sort of minimalist, casual, feminine designs that tend to be usable for businesses like beauty, fashion, or bakery. All right, now it's time to head back to Canva and click Create a Design. You can use Canva's suggested business card size, or you can input your own. Now you're presented with a blank slate to create your design. As I mentioned earlier, you cannot use any of these pre-made Canva templates if you're planning on selling them. You can use them as inspiration, but you'll need to be very careful not to copy any of these designs. I'm going to start by clicking this text menu and just inserting temp text for initial layout design. I'm pretty happy with the layout so far, so now I'm going to head to the Elements tab to find some beautiful graphics that I can input into my design. Again, choose only the free elements. I'm happy with this design so far, but I'm going to add another page so that I can design the front and back of this business card. Alrighty, so my template is done. You can see that my customers can customize my template by inputting their own names, address information, etc. To turn this into something that I can sell, click on the share button and click template link. Now this template link is what you're going to be selling, but you obviously can't just give people a random URL text when they purchase your Canva templates. So let's actually create a PDF file that you can automatically send to your customers as soon as they purchase your Canva template. I'm going to go back to Canva's homepage here and click Create a Design. I'm going to choose the A4 size, but you can really choose anything you want. Over here, I'll be putting some instructions on how my customers can use my Canva templates, and the most important part is to include the template link that I created earlier. Now I'm going to download this PDF because this PDF is the file that I'm going to be selling and automatically delivering to my customers when they complete purchases on my online store. Now that you have a product that's ready for sale, it's time to set up your online store so customers can actually purchase your Canva templates. There are various platforms that you can use to sell your Canva templates, but I recommend creating your own website or online store using payhip because it's completely free and it's also the most affordable in comparison to other platforms like Shopify or Etsy. To be clear, you can create your own website for free with payhip and also create an online store on Etsy at the same time. This way you can enjoy the best of both worlds. Now go to payhip.com and sign up for a new account. Once you've signed up, we recommend starting by setting up your payment information to ensure that you can get paid once your orders start pouring into your store. Go to Account, then Settings. Next, click on the Payment Details tab. Payhip provides instant payout through our secure payment processors Stripe and PayPal. You can connect to one or both of our payment processors. We recommend connecting to both so you can provide as many payment options as possible to your customers. If you don't have an account with Stripe or PayPal yet, don't worry, it takes less than 10 minutes to set up. Just follow the instructions that appear once you click these buttons. Now let's upload your Canva template as a product listing on your online store. Go to the Product tab on the top menu bar. Next, click Add New Product. Select the Digital Product category. You can sell any kind of digital files such as PDFs or basically anything that you can save on your computer. Upload the PDF product file that you created earlier over here. Payhip will instantly and automatically deliver this file to your customers when they purchase this item, so you can literally earn money while you're asleep. Input your product title, price, images, and descriptions. Remember that you can write rich product descriptions that include images, videos, bullet points, and more. Next, choose your visibility settings. You can set your product as invisible if you're still working on it and do not want it to be accessible by the general public yet. You can also make it unlisted so that it's only accessible to certain customers that have access to your product URL. You can also choose to include this product as part of one or more collections within your store. If this is your very first product, you won't be able to see the collection option yet. But once you have more than one product, you'll be able to see an option to create product collections. Click the advanced options to view any other settings that you can set up for your product. Once you're done, click Add Product to publish your listing. You'll be presented with the URL to the specific product that you have just published. Now at this point, you're all set to start selling your Canva templates. You can promote them on your social media and more. But I'll show you how to take your online store to the next level by customizing the design. To do this, go to the Store tab and launch your store builder. Payhip provides a lot of pre-built website sections that you can select from and customize accordingly. No technical skills needed. And yes, this feature is also completely free. There's a more comprehensive tutorial on how to use Payhip Store Builder tool, so we're going to link it in the description box below. Now let's take a look at what your product listing looks like to your potential customers. Over here, you'll see what your customers will go through when they're purchasing your product. You'll notice that your customers will only need to input their email address and their payment information, and there's no shipping addresses because this is a digital product. This also helps to make the purchase experience more seamless for your customers. As soon as they finish the payment process, they'll be presented with the links to download your product files. They'll also receive an automated email containing links to download your product files as well. In this case, they'll be receiving the PDF file containing your Canva template link. As you can see, once I click the template link, I'll be able to customize it to my liking. You can have a peace of mind as any changes that your customers make on their templates will not affect your original template. Now it's time to answer some frequently asked questions. First, how to prevent people from stealing your Canva templates? There are a couple of ways that you can do this. One, you can create a watermark for your templates. Adding a watermark to your templates is a simple way to identify that you're the original creator for the template. You can add your logo or business name as a transparent overlay to your design. This is our most recommended method. You can also activate PDF stamping via Payhip so that every single PDF that you sell will have the unique customer information who purchased it. What should I upload as my product listing thumbnail when I sell my Canva templates? So this is completely up to you, but I really recommend creating a product mockup of your Canva template. So going back to my business card template earlier, I created this mockup on Canva, so it's a little more aesthetic and hopefully my customers can better visualize the end product with the help of these background aesthetics. That's it for today's video. Visit payhip.com/blog for more helpful tips on how to sell Canva templates online or Canva template ideas. You can also reach out to contact@payhip.com if you have any questions about your Payhip online store. Have fun selling your Canva templates and talk to you soon!